My name is Michael Tiller. I'm the president and founder of Xogeny'S. Xogeny'S is a company I founded to really explore the combination of modeling, engineering, and newer technologies like web and cloud-based technologies. I've also worked on the Modelica Association board since it started. I'm involved in a couple of other organizations, and I've written now two books on Modelica as well. I think open standards are really important because otherwise, we in engineering, we risk sort of fragmenting ourselves into small markets, and it becomes very difficult for tool vendors to serve those small markets. And by adopting standards, we aggregate that market together. We allow tool vendors to dedicate more resources to serving our needs, and ultimately that benefits us as an engineering community. Taking my company as just an example, one of the reasons I chose FMI was because I wanted to develop capabilities to help people simulate things in the cloud, and I wanted to make that accessible to all the different tools or users of all the different tools. And FMI is a technology that allows me to do that because I can, because of the large number of tools that now export FMUs, you know, using FMI, I'm able to serve all of those customers with the capabilities I develop instead of having to develop a custom solution for each particular tool, which would be more resources than I can really afford to devote to that effort. There's an enormous amount of innovation going on in the tech sector. And part of that is that they are also very focused on standards. And we need, as an engineering community, to learn that, because the part of the reason they're so successful and they have so much innovation and new things come out all the time is because they're very careful about these kinds of things. You look at a browser, a modern browser. For example, yesterday I unveiled that book. That book is doing so many different things. In many of my examples, I'm using structured or scalable vector graphics, I'm using WebGL, I'm using HTML, I'm using CSS, I'm using JavaScript. Those, and I can run it across all these different browsers. How is that, right? These are different tools, and everything just works across all these different implementations. And part of that is that emphasis on standards. And I think we see in the tech community, there's been a huge benefit from them really beating up people like Microsoft to conform to these standards. And in fact, in many cases, going their own way, just saying, okay, you know what? It doesn't even work in IE because Microsoft refuses to play. And I think that's costing Microsoft, because Internet Explorer is frankly kind of a joke in the tech community. I think they've realized now that they have to be conformant. And what you see now is that in the tech industry is this stability that allows a tremendous amount of growth and innovation on top of it. And I think from the engineering side, we need to pay attention to that lesson, because obviously we want innovation and we want growth as well. And there's a lesson to be learned there about the importance that standards can play in allowing the ecosystem to really grow in that kind of way, in a safe, stable way.